Hey everyone, it is Wednesday and somebody's hitting the camera with his bubbles. I wanted to give you an update. We are actually outside. There's Belle. There's bubbles floating past. Hi Belle. What are you doing? Yeah, we're outside. The weather is gorgeous. It's in the mid 50s. I don't even have a coat on. I have a short sleeve shirt on. It is so nice. Obviously, I have my unicorn slippers on. They have replaced the piggy slippers. The piggy slippers got holes in them, so now we're going with the unicorns. So this is my second book that I'm starting this week. I'm really excited about it. I love my first Abby Glenn's that I read as a review book, and now I got this one from, I don't remember where I ordered this one from, but I got this one recently. So I'm gonna pick up this one until Friday night. Here is my bookmark, Sammy. You'll be loving this little bookmark. It looks like her little Buzz, her little hedgehog. So this is the story of a boy who's really popular at school, and everybody loves him and seems like he has the perfect life, but he doesn't actually have the perfect life. He has some sort of deep pain or something like that inside, and then he meets this girl who he feels like he can confide in, but she witnessed her father kill her mother, so she stopped talking after that, so she doesn't talk. So I think it's going to be really good. It's going to be a really quick read. As you can see, the font is huge. I'll get it for you in a minute. And so I'm going to read this while we're hanging out here in between playing. We've been doing some chalk art. As you can see, our porch seriously needs to get painted this year. We've been putting it off for like 2 years, but we're going to need to do that this summer. So anyways, we're going to do that and read and blow bubbles and do chalks and play on the slide. We have a little slide out here for him. And then it'll be time to go inside for a nap. So I'll catch up with you guys in the next episode.
Just a quick update. My husband and son are inside playing. So just coloring right now. I finished my book this morning, which was really nice. I got some time to just relax and lay on the couch and read and have coffee. And it was so nice. Vacation is so nice. And now I started a new Abby Glines book. So I have that. And Amelia and I spent almost 2 hours outside on the porch this morning, which was really nice. I set up a little clubhouse for him, and he had so much fun. And then when Frank came home, he brought dinner home, which was really super nice. And we went for a really long walk tonight. All of us, the dogs, everyone, we all went for a really long walk, and it was so nice. Such nice weather. It was nearly 60 degrees today. So what a treat, because we don't usually get that around here in February. So I'm just going to flip you around, show you what I'm working on.
So here is what I'm working on. I'm doing the little bunny from, I don't even know which book this is. Is this Rhapsody in the Forest? No, this is the Menuet des Bonheurs book. So working on this right now. I'm doing his little jacket or his kimono, whatever you call that. I've really gone back into working with my polychromos the last week. I've fallen back in love with those guys. Not that I like them more than my Holbeins, because my true love are my Holbeins, but I've been really enjoying working with these again. I forgot how much I like them. So I'm using my polychromos and of course my Holbeins for this part. So I've been using varied pencils. I actually used my Prismacolors on the flowers, and I use some of my Pablo pencils on the butterflies, and now I'm working on this. So I have a few more minutes of working on this, and then I'm going to go take a shower, and then Amelia will take his bath, and then I will put him to bed. So that'll take at least like an hour, and then I'm not sure if I'm gonna color tonight or read or do both, so we will see, and I will update you. Good morning, everyone. It's Saturday morning. I haven't filmed for the last 2 days because it has been dark and cloudy and crummy, and I have felt crummy, so I haven't been filming the last 2 days, but today's gonna be a fun day. We have fun things to do this weekend, so I wanted to just give you a quick update. It's Saturday morning at 10 after 10, and having my deli coffee. You know, I look forward to that on the weekends. And Frank's on his way home. He had a quick measure this morning, so he's doing that, and he's on his way home now. So I already have Amelia ready. I did my chores already this morning. I actually went in the back of the entertainment center and cleaned out all the dust bunnies and all that kind of thing. So did that, and now I'm working on this. I've just really felt like working in Romantic Country. And I had already done this page, you guys remember, on one of the cozy coloring nights, which we'll be going back to doing. I've had too much going on to plan one, but Sammy and I definitely intend to continue doing those. So you might remember, I don't even know if I ever showed you the completed picture. So this was my completed picture of what I started on Cozy Coloring Night. I think I did this with all my Holbeins, that's I'm pretty sure. Because I'm pretty sure this is a Holbein color that none of the other sets have. So yeah. Anyways, so I decided to do that. This book is Romantic Country 3. It's my favorite one. This is, I actually had a lot more pictures done in this book, but you may have remembered when I had a fire last year, like in July, my book singed and part of it burned up. So I had to get rid of the book actually, and I bought a new one and I saved what pictures I could, but I don't know where they are at the moment. They're not in here. So I think they're in a folder, but yeah, doesn't make any difference. Anyway, so this is what I'm working on. I just decided to do this one. It just, you know how something just strikes you and you're like, I want to do that one, even though it was just buildings. I wanted to do the bookstore to make it look like Barnes & Noble. So it is Frank's bookstore, so you know, there's that. And I wanted to do it the colors of Barnes & Noble. And then we have a little, I guess it's like a candle store. It says Aroma, so I guess it's like a candle or fragrance store. And a little restaurant here. And I'm using my Polychromos. Can you believe it? I'm big into my Polychromos at the moment. I don't know why. I just switched over to those and I miss them. So I'm giving them some love and giving the Holbeins a break because they've been going nonstop on all my coloring things. So I'm not going to show you guys myself right now because, you know, I don't want to scare the internet, but I'll show you guys myself later. We have a lot of things to do today, and I will vlog some of what we do. Thank you so much for, I'm just going to move my chair. Thank you so much for everyone that's been enjoying the vlogs. I appreciate you watching. I've gotten coloring and reading videos up this week, and I wanted to show you. I bought this at the Disney store. I just saw Frank go by, so I'm going to have to cut this short. But I bought this reusable bag at the Disney store. It's not like a regular square type bag. It's a rectangle bag. And I've moved my coloring things into it to see if I like it better than this for right now. Because this doesn't hold all my stuff at the moment. So I'm thinking of repurposing this for something else for right now. But you know I switch around. But since this bag is so big, it can fit a lot, plus two sets of like pencils that I want to carry around. So I switched over to that. That is what is going on. We are going to do some book shopping and food eating and lots of fun things today. So you'll be with us and I'll see you. Okay, I just wanted to film this quick little bit. We're getting ready to go out the door. It's 11:45 and I have to show you this. We got this at Target last week in the dollar spot. Isn't that cute? I had to have it. It's just so adorable. I have a pink one. A little bit smaller that with the It's So Fluffy unicorn on it that I have in my Disney bag. I don't even know where we got that. It might have been like Universal Studio Store or something like that. Or it could have been Toys R Us because they have it up there too. But either way, this I got at Target and I love it. And this is my Modelo bag. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing it right, but it's, you know, you can see my reflection in it. It's that Modelo from London. This is actually the Pippa Middleton bag. Do you guys remember when, of course you remember when Kate and Will got married, Pippa was carrying this bag and it became like the it bag and my mom ordered it from London for me and it's got so many zippers and fun little places in it and I have my Figment wallet that my mom got me for Christmas in there and all my goodies and it just has a ton of zippers and I can't open this with one hand but I just love all my fun zippers. And there's my son's bunny and my Barnes & Noble coupons. So we're going to hit the road. Can you say bye-bye?
Bye-bye.
And we'll see you in a bit. We're making a little stop at Chick-fil-A for lunch. As you guys know, it's one of our favorites. How do you feel about this?
Yum.
We're going into Pets Warehouse now. We just came from Sears because they're going out of business in front of Sears. So, going into the Pet Warehouse. They used to have a lot of fish here. And Emilio's really big into fish at the moment. So we're going to see what they
have. A fish! You mommy!
Look at that big fish.
So I just wanted to show you what I got today. I didn't actually buy any books, but when I came home, I had some books waiting. So I got this advanced copy of She Was the Quiet One from Michelle Campbell. These were a surprise. I didn't know they were coming. And this one is the story of twin girls. And the condensed story of it is that the one girl is good, straight, narrow, path, all that, you know, stuff. The other one's a bad one. Gets involved with a teacher's husband and double crosses her sister, and it says that only one twin can survive. So that sounds really super good. St. Martin's is always really good to me. I have some contacts over there, and they just send me stuff that they think I might like, and that was so awesome of them. So I really appreciate these books. And this one I'm so flippin' excited for. This is the Lost for Words Bookshop by Stephanie Butland. Is that right? What would you say? That's what I would say. Butland? Well, whatever. This is a story of... Let me actually read you what it says. Because this is a book about books, and book lovers are going to love it. So I don't want to screw it up. It says, Butland's Bibliophile's Delight introduces the endearing Loveday Carew, an eccentric young woman with a secret past whose sanctuary is Lost for Words, the charming used bookstore in which she works. Working in a secondhand bookshop suits 25-year-old Loveday just fine. There, she comfortably carries on with her antisocial existence, sorting and filing books, and leaves the socializing to Archie, the shop's most gregarious owner. But then, into her refuge comes a charming poet/magician, and not long after that, three mysterious packages. Someone knows about her traumatic past, what she's mentally branded the incident. Unable to hide any longer, Loveday is forced to emerge from her prickly and private shell, summon up the courage to right a heartbreaking wrong, and make sense of her past, her present, and her future in this rare and beautiful novel. So, books about books sounds freaking awesome, and I'm so excited. It's probably gonna have some maybe magical realism type thing. I'm not sure, but either way, I'm so excited to read this. It's got some nice dark big prints. So these are both adult books, so they're not young adult books. So really super excited. I love giant books like this. How awesome is a big giant book? You never get books like this. I don't really think I have any that are like finished copies that are this size, so that's awesome. I mean, hardcovers, yes, but no paperbacks. So, very excited for those. Thank you so much to the publisher for them. I will be reading and enjoying them. Oh, and this one comes out in July. Actually, the day after my birthday. This, She Was the Quiet One. And the bookshop one comes out, I'll tell you in a second, June. I don't know what date does it say. Just says June 2018, so I'll have to get back to you, but we have some months, but I'm not going to be able to wait to read this one, so probably as soon as I get done with my current reads, I'm reading two books right now, I'm going to have to read that one. So, I want to show you what I got from Sephora, because, yeah, I didn't go to get this at Sephora, but I ended up getting it anyway. Tati, are you seeing this? Mm-hmm. This is the Too Faced Life's a Festival palette. Not even joking you, I hemmed and hawed for like 25 minutes on this. I must have swatched it like 3 times. I can't even remember the last time I actually bought a eyeshadow palette. But this is a limited edition one. And it's beautiful. First of all, the packaging is just awesome. This is like a very puffy type packaging. And here are the, you get a nice little mirror there, and then you get these beautiful shades, and they are all iridescent. I don't know if you can really tell. Let me see if I can hold it up so you can get an idea. Look at the unicorn tears. I have to swatch that one for you so you can see. You could definitely see the artist pass. This is Dusk Till Dawn, Fantasy, Mystic, Rain. I don't know if you can see how awesome that is, but Beamin', Desert Vibes, Rainbow Life, Sunset Dream, Fun in the Sun, and Fireflies. And let me swatch the Unicorn Kisses, Unicorn Tears for you. Hold on, let me swatch it on my hand and then see if you'll be able, I don't know if you're going to be able to see it because it's so, oh, okay, you'll be able to see it now with two coats on it. But I would put a base under these so that you can get the full color, but can you see that? Can you see the Unicorn Tears? When I was in my 20s, I had a color just like that from Mandy's. It was like just makeup from Mandy's. And oh my gosh, when I saw this, I was like, how can I resist? And I walked back and forth a few times, and the lady finally said to me, she's like, do you need help with something? And I was like, oh, I don't know, am I too old for this? And she's like, no. She probably just told me that anyway, even if I was like 80. But you know what? I decided to get it because it was limited edition, and I always do this, and Frank always gets mad at me. I always say, you know what? I'm going to think about it. And then I think about it, or I see it, like somebody else have it on YouTube, and I'm like, oh my God, now I really want it, and I can never find it. I can't order it online. It's sold out everywhere. So this time I just decided to bite the bullet and get it. So I got that, and what I went for, actually, I went for another one of these. Mine is completely out. I'm like scraping the bottom of the barrel. The NARS Smudge Proof Eyeshadow. I love this stuff. My makeup just does not even stay on without this stuff anymore, not even my eyeliner. So I desperately needed another one of these. And then I heard Makeup by Tiffany D talking about this. This is the new Bobbi Brown Skin Longwear Weightless Foundation. It has SPF 15. She said it's full cover, and she said with it, she did put it on, and she said when she used it, and she showed herself with it when she was all done with her bronzer and everything, that she did not even need under eye concealer, and that it wasn't cakey. And sometimes I do find that my stuff gets cakey, so I needed new under eye concealer, so I thought, you know what, let me give this a try. I'm in the market for a new foundation. I don't wear very much face makeup, but the foundation that I'm wearing right now, I'm like not 100% pleased with it at the moment, so I thought I'd give this a try. They're about the same price, so it's not even about that. I just wanted to give this a try and see if I like it better. It's supposed to be full coverage, so we'll see. I'm going to give it a try out, and I'll let you guys know probably tomorrow. I'm going to wear all my new stuff tomorrow, and yeah, that's that. So, hi, Jack. How are you? How you doing, Jack? So, I don't think I let you guys know about Mr. Jack here. We went to the vet on Tuesday for his next appointment, and she said, hi, little bear. She said that he's actually doing good. She said as far as treatment goes, there's really nothing else we could do for him. We just need to let him heal and let it be what it is at this point. It's not bothering him. It's not hindering him. He's eating. Come here, boys. They're eating. Well, not them. Like they are, but Jack, he's eating. Hi, Jack. You want to go out? Jack, you want to go out? You want to go out, little bear? Yeah. Little bear wants to go out. Oh, Jack wants to go out. Yeah. So she said to keep giving him the eye lubrication stuff, like 6 times a day if we can, no less than 4. And just let him be. And she said if we notice any difference to let her know and go from there. But other than that, he doesn't have to go back for any more visits. It's not bothering him. He can see fine and everything looks good. So thank you so much for all of your prayers and your good thoughts and you guys sending me comments and messages and stuff asking me about him. He's doing better, and I really believe it has to do with all the prayers and good thoughts you guys sent our way. So thank you so much. So now we are going to probably feed them and order something for dinner. It's raining, so we're going to have a nice quiet night in, maybe watch some movies, do some coloring, do some reading. maybe games. I don't know. We'll see what we're going to do, but it's going to be a good night. Little man pooped on the potty before, so I'm so excited about that because we're finally starting to move in the next direction of potty training. He goes, he just doesn't tell us when he has to go. So we're really working with him on it. But yeah, so it's been a good day, and we have more stuff coming up tomorrow. So I'm sure I'll still update you later on tonight when I decide what I'm going to be reading and or coloring. Look at them. Jack is always cleaning Little Bear's eyes. He loves to take care of his brother. He loves his brother so much. They've been together for their entire existence, these two. Oh, are they sweet? Who doesn't like to watch a little pug love?
Hi, everyone. Yeah. Just doing an update. Yeah. Haven't done any updates, I don't think, today. Yeah. Maybe one this morning. I can't remember. So, remember yesterday I told you I bought that foundation? Well, I returned it already today. There was actually nothing wrong with it. It was really nice, but it was too dry on my face. It would be really, really good for somebody with oily skin. I think that would work out really well for them. I actually really like the foundation, the Bobbi Brown, what was it, Weightless something? Frank's dancing for me.
Like Bobbi Brown.
So... Yeah, so I really liked it, and I liked the color, and I thought it was really good. It was full coverage, but I didn't feel like it was too thick. Once it actually, I have it on still right now, but I don't know how much is actually still on, because I put it on really early this morning. Once you let it set, you don't have to put a powder on it. It's really nice. It's got good coverage, and I liked it, but it just was too dry for my face, and it was really looked like cakey. So I returned it, and Sephora is great like that. They just take stuff back, and I only bought it yesterday. But still, not every place would take something like that back, so I was lucky that they will do that. That's their policy. So I picked up this instead. This is the It CC Cream, the under eye, or it's just like, it says color correcting, full coverage cream, and anti-aging SPF 50. Emilio is trying to help Dad cook. So I picked this up. This is just a sample size. It was $15, but there's a good amount in here for what I'm going to use it for concealer. I like it, and I actually put it on, you can't see it anymore, it's off by now, because I put it on much earlier today, and I've been rubbing my face and my eyes, but I like it a lot, so there's that. Yeah, I like it a lot, so there's that, and I'm happy I picked that up. And I used my Unicorn, eyeshadow today, which again you can't really see, it's off by now because it's a quarter after seven, so it's been many hours since I've had that on. Some little man got a haircut today. Show them your haircut. Nope, sorry, can't see the haircut right now. Dad also got a haircut, and we were laughing so hard at the barber because there was a little bit of a wait when we walked in, and there was a little girl in there with her dad, and she was playing, and Emilio walked over to her, and he said to her, "Hi, I'm Boy, and this is my mommy and daddy." And it was so funny. He thinks his name is Boy. I don't know why he thinks that, because you guys hear me all the time saying Emilio. But I think he knows his name is Emilio because he has said it a few times, but I think it's hard for him to say still at this point, so he calls himself Boy. And every time I say to him, "What's your name?" he tells me Boy. So I thought he was so cute. He was just like, "Hi, I'm Boy." And she was just staring at him. I don't think she spoke much English, but it was really funny. So we did that today. We went to the barber. The boys got cuts, and they all look handsome and snazzy. I mean, they always look handsome and snazzy, but they look even more so now. And we went to Barnes & Noble again. I was there yesterday. I didn't buy anything yesterday. And Frank was sad that I didn't buy anything yesterday, so he said, "We're going back today, and you're going to get something." So I did. And we went to the diner because my son is now obsessed with diners. And every time we passed the diner, he was like, "I want to go to a diner." So I don't know how he knows places that we've never been to before are diners, but somehow he knows what a diner looks like. And he keeps saying, "I want to go to the diner." So we did that. And then we came home, and no one really napped, but we all kind of just rested. I read my book a little bit. I'm still reading that Abby Glines book. Let me see if I do have it down here. This one, the Under Friday Night, Under Friday Night, Until Friday Night. I'm still reading that. Really enjoying that. And I'll show you what I got at Barnes & Noble. Let me flip you around and I'll show you.
Oh, and here's my picture. Still working on this one. Not that much more to go, actually. Been really enjoying just working on this one. It's kind of simple, but yeah, that's what I've been doing. So I got this bookmark. This was a new one this week. Just one more chapter with the little owl. Or as Amelia calls it, hoo-hoos. Got that. I got this, which I was excited to find, The Outliers by Kimberly McCrae. I've wanted to read this for a long time, and this was the only one they have. It was a bargain book, and I think maybe because it's a little ripped, but I don't care. For $5-6, actually it was probably about $5 at my discount. I was like, oh yeah, so I got me a copy of that. Nice big print. Yeah, so there's that. And for my book that I could use my, because Barnes & Noble sent out a thing of coupons this week, and one of them was for 20% off a mystery book. I picked this one, Death of an Avid Reader by Frances Brody, and this is a Kate Shackleton mystery. I have not read any of the other Kate Shackleton mysteries, but you know, this is a book about books. And I have wanted to read this for such a long time, since before it came out in hardcover, and it's so expensive on the Nook. It's like $16 on the Nook, and I'm not willing to pay $16 for an ebook. And every time we go to Barnes & Noble, I just never even think about it. But today, I went into the mystery section, and I was just perusing, and I saw it. It was the only one that they had. They didn't have very many Frances Brody books at all, but they did have this one. And this one is about a ghost in a library. So I am so all about that. I'm so there. So, yeah, that's all that I got at Barnes & Noble, but that is wonderful. I'm very excited about those. And, yeah, so that's my coloring. We made some coconut cookies before. I'll show you what Frank is actually cooking. Hello, Jack. How are you? How are you doing? So here's Frank's spice drawer. And here's what Frank's making right now. He's making us some, what are these? Grilled? Or baked root vegetables. So we have red skin potatoes, carrots, sweet potatoes, and I think he's chopping up the onion right now. Brussels sprouts. We need onion in here too. So here's these big giant Brussels sprouts he's got going on. These are so good. If you guys haven't had these like baked or sauteed or whatever the heck they are so delicious. I'm not a huge fan of Brussels sprouts just like this. But when you cook them up and they brown and they get all toasty, those are delicious. I could eat those all day long. So we're going to have this with a few things, you know, a few meals that we have this week. And these are the toasted coconut cookies we made before. They were just like packaged cookies from Stop and Shop, but this is Stop and Shop's flavor of the month. So every month they have a different type of flavor and or theme for whatever, you know, products they have, and this was one of the ones they had, and these are delicious. Frank and I shared one. We only had one, and we shared it. These won't last the rest of the week. There's not that many, thank goodness, but they are delicious. Once my mom gets her hands on those, that's it. They are goners. So, that's it. That's list update. Never mind my messy living room. You guys know, I have a 3-year-old. He's messy. So be it. Jack's obviously watching the iPad in there. Jack, what are you watching? Hey guys, sorry for the abrupt ending, but I wanted to just sign off and say goodbye. I didn't end up filming anything else, but I will be filming again this week. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.